Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. Today's episode will begin by looking at a few standard SpaceX updates, then we'll head over to Boca Chica and see what's happening around the facility with SN5, SN6 and SN7. Let's head straight in and get up to date. Starting with the upcoming launch of Starlink 8 with some SkySat satellites. As you can see on the SpaceXFans website, it's currently scheduled to lift off on Saturday, June 13th at 1 a.m. UTC or Friday, June 12th at 9 p.m. EDT. As is expected a few days prior to launch, the Of Course I Still Love You drone ship has departed Port Canaveral. It is now headed out to sea to position itself for the currently unknown booster that will launch Starlink 8. The recently launched booster B1049.5, which lifted off carrying Starlink 7, has returned to port aboard Just Read the Instructions. I think it's crazy cool to see how a booster looks after 5 flights to and from space. As mentioned last episode, the Of Course I Still Love You Octagrabber is upgraded. However, the Octagrabber you can see here on Just Read the Instructions is the new one we recently saw being constructed. According to this Space Flight Now article, NASA anticipates the return of Bob and Doug to take place around August. Apparently, they wanted to see how Dragon performed before setting a proper return date, and Dragon is apparently doing very well. This resulted in them deciding to keep the men up there for a month or two. Just going to chuck this in because I think it's really cool. However, here is a video of the fairing deploy sequence on a Starlink mission. Now over to Boca Chica, where further preparations have been taking place. Here you can see some new pipes that have arrived at the launch area. Also, over by the Starship Superheavy launch pad, a new metal structure was spotted. I have read that this is possibly an auger or pile driver. Based on what I've read, the idea is that this will help create the foundations for a tall building. So this could potentially be the start of a launch tower or maybe some sort of crane for stacking the whole rocket. Let me know your thoughts down in the comments. At the fuel farm, SpaceXers have been doing further work on tanks. As you can see here, there is a tank currently being painted. As we saw last episode, the old SN4 mount that got destroyed by the explosion was replaced. Engineers have continued to work on it and you can see the new ground support equipment from last episode. Apparently, this is the replacement for the quick disconnect, which is what caused the destruction of SN4. Also, the hydraulic rams which we saw for previous test vehicles has risen. SpaceX have been reassembling them as they plan to do more thrust simulation testing. You can see here that they have reattached the legs to support the load of the rams. Interestingly, the unit is painted white this time. Then finally, they lifted and lowered the hydraulic rams into the test stand. We were expecting an SN5 rollout potentially Monday, but that didn't happen as you can see. Something else I would like to show you are some clips from Alex Rex's recent virtual flyover. As highlighted here, SpaceX have been working on an area in the construction yard for a high bay shaped building. As per last video, Elon Musk tweeted about an 81 meter tall high bay, so this is probably where it's going. Alex added a great bit to his video where he visualized how this new high bay could look. You can see it will be quite a bit taller than the existing high bay, and as Elon mentioned, it will be used for super heavy stacking. Next up, we have a couple of tweets from Elon Musk regarding Lunar Starship. Musk was asked about the Lunar Starship's thruster differences to a standard Starship. He responded to say, "Forward thrusters are to stabilize ship when landing in high winds. If goal is max payload to moon per ship, no heat shield or flaps or big gas thruster packs are needed. No need to bring early ships back. They can serve as part of Moonbase Alpha." After this, he was asked in a response tweet, "Are the landing legs the same as on standard Starship, or do they specifically accommodate for lunar surface?" Elon Musk responded with, "We are working on new legs, wider stance and able to auto level. Important for leaning into wind and landing on rocky and pitted surfaces." Now let's take a look at the work with SN6. As you can see here, the thrust section has been stacked further and is now full size. SN6 might get stacked before SN5 even rolls out. You can also see that the lifting mechanism has also been hooked up. It's just a matter of days now before we get to see a full SN6 tank sitting in the high bay. The new nose cone we recently saw under construction and I'm assuming is for SN6 is now outside. You can see here it still needs to be hooked up to a tapered section, most likely that piece in front to become full height. Before we take a look at some SN7, here you can see a little sneaky nose cone tip. It's currently sitting outside next to the nose cone we just saw, so this could be the start of SN7's nose cone. Finally, the newest member of the family who we've seen quite a bit of recently, SN7. This dome, as you can see, was recently flipped over. It's an interesting bulkhead we have here because it looks like none of the domes we've seen previously. Upper domes don't have a hole in them. Common bulkheads have a bigger hole, as does the very bottom dome. So it will be very interesting to see how this is used. As always, a huge thank you goes to Mary Boca Chica Girl for capturing and to NSF for sharing this incredible footage. Also, thanks to Carl Montgomery and Julia Burgeon for their amazing work at Port Canaveral, as it's been quite busy there recently. If you haven't noticed, I've created myself an upload schedule. The reason being that whilst I'm currently on furlough, at some point I'll probably have to go back to my full-time job. So be sure to come back every Wednesday and Sunday for a new update video. That's it for this episode of the SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.